Does it fall apart there? And does Liquid test that now? Do they wait for playoffs? I assume you would to play for the first round bye, but if Liquid are just saying screw it playoffs, maybe they don't.
Here's the other thing. If you know that he's going to be cornered into those champions, I really like Rek'Sai into Evelynn. Playing Rek'Sai against Evelynn is very, very easy. It takes away a lot of her later game flanking abilities because of the passive, but also Rek'Sai can answer Evelynn's early game moves. And her ultimate, being able to get back out on the map, allows Rek'Sai to reposition very quickly and deal with the pressure that she tries to put out. So that's definitely a possibility for... Nope, not a possibility anymore. That's the last ban.
Well, I'm glad you brought that up, though, because it speaks to how good that ban is, then, if Rush wants Evelynn on this pick right here to make sure that counter pick isn't there. It's a really intelligent pivot by Impulse. Of course, they pretty much have to ban Ryze, but they choose to ban the Kalista away. Surprising to me because it left that Sivir easily up for Piglet. And now Impulse deciding what they really want to go for here. Of course, there's plenty of strong top laners out there. I don't quite understand the pecking order myself. It seems like every team has their own priorities, what they find best.
Well, these are definitely things that Team Impulse have shown over the last couple of weeks very clearly. The global teleport from Shen, Alistar is always big for Adrian, and the speed boost taking away Sivir. So those are pretty big takeaways from Team Liquid in the early stages of the pick ban.
Yeah, there we go. That's the scary thing, is the Azir, of course, was left up for Phoenix Gate.
Undefeated on it.
So is Gate, to be fair, but yeah.
True.
No, not the same, but to the fact that Gate could have played it and could have chosen to take it away, but Impulse, knowing this Azir is up, chose to pick a disengaged focus team, play the poke, right? Get the Kog'Maw right away and say, hey, we steal this away from Piglet. We also let Gate play a poke champion. We tend to see poke be the intended or the popular counterpick to these mid-range mages like Azir, Cassio, and Viktor.
Yeah. I mean, you do have Janna, so you locked in some disengage with your Kog'Maw. Sivir boosted Maokai is always pretty scary.
Very true.
And we can see Apollo play Kog'Maw. He has in the past.
Very true as well.
So it is also a flex pick here for Impulse, allowing Gate to wait and sit on his counter pick a little bit longer.
And that was a win over TSM when he played Kog'Maw, the only time he's played it this split. But they played a whole bunch of support, and that was the case.
So Neeson
does come through. No jungler yet picked for Team Liquid. They're pretty much opposite champion pools here. Rush was going to go for the Lee Sin, if not the Evelynn, playing something more disengaged focused. Also, they pick a split pusher for Impact. We had seen Balls do a great job on his Gnar matchup, and he got pretty far ahead. They won that game. Quas will be playing Maokai, and Team Liquid need a jungler and support to round things out.
Do they really want to get that much dive to get back to Kog'Maw to lock in something like an Olaf?
Evelynn dominates an Olaf player. No, nope, they find Annie for it, though. Xpecial doesn't always get to play Annie, but when he does...
He misses a lot of
sometimes
ultimates.
Misses Timbers, I suppose.
I was
going for the Dos Equis joke, and then I kind of failed it. I don't always play Annie, but when I do, sometimes my Timbers miss.
Yeah, it's been kind of touch and go for him, honestly, on the Annie play. He's obviously not scared of going back to it, though. So we'll see what it turns out to be this time around. But they do have. It's very scary when you combo Annie with Sivir because of how forceful the engage is. This Sivir go button with Maokai and Annie is really, really good hard engage for that Kog'Maw. They want to get to that back line.
Yeah.
And even Janna has problems dealing with that amount of engage.
And I want to know what kind of team comp Impulse is looking for. Mid-range mage comes in, so it is going to be Viktor mid after all up against Azir. This is one of the more storied matchups in the mid lane, but you don't have bans coming through on that one. So a team fight-based team, but not a lot of gank assistance for the Lee Sin from Team Impulse. Meanwhile, Liquid, a very aggressive team, they can go all in. And they got Phoenix and Piglet to back them up for damage.
I feel like Liquid have come out pretty well in this champion select.
I agree.
They've got a lot of tools that they've been able to use successfully in the past. And there's a lot of pressure on Gate in this game. Didn't have to pull out too much yesterday. Now he's going to have to keep up against Phoenix Azir. And yep. He's going to have to worry about the roaming Annie ganks. Viktor doesn't have escapes from him of his own, so he always has to be very wary and support roams. Not to mention being comboed with Gragas.
Yeah, it's a very scary team. The direction is definitely forward for Team Liquid.
Yeah. Yesterday, though, it was pretty funny on Twitter after the games. There was a lot of back and forth because these guys are all really good friends. Rush was talking about how Phoenix used to be very scared because I'm only camping mid tomorrow. He saw how much damage Rush did to champions in their last game, and he was like, wow, that's ridiculous on Evelyn. He's like, I'm coming for you, bud.
Well, good luck then to Phoenix in this one. You guys know the deal, of course. We want your game prediction for this match. Tweet at Level Esports with hashtag TLWin or hashtag TIPWin. Let us know who's going to take this one home. Winner ties for first place. Loser is going to be in the quarterfinals in third or fourth. We are getting into the game. Let's go.
We will. Well, let's see. Who will be rocked and who will be... Well, that's it.
Do they see anything about themselves or is it just the opponents that they rock?
No, we're just going to rock you. We are champions. That's what they say about themselves.
That's true. In the same song.
The champions.
My friends.
Well, line of scrimmage is set. And Xpecial actually has the advantage in that support versus support early because he's got the spell thieves. Should have tried to go for an auto attack there.
Darn right.
In my opinion.
I actually really don't like spell thieves Annie that much. It's harder for her to get the poke and the damage in, and Xpecial's just going to go for a talisman later anyway. It does allow you the burst for an all-in. Adrian will happily earn a crap ton of gold. And I think without Team Liquid getting a jungler in, they won't win a 2-on-2. Kog'Maw can just damage Piglet through his spell shield.
Yeah. I was actually keeping track of the gold earned yesterday because there was a game of Spell Thieves versus Coin, and they were on par. They were very, very similar up until it was like 10 minutes when I last checked.
Yeah, when you leave laning phase, Spell Thieves kind of falls off.
And they were very close. All right. Well, Phoenix going to get the early advantage here. Experience from the three small Raptors, as Quas has set him up for success in the mid lane. We will see. Where's Rush go early? Lane swap here from Team Impulse as they send Kog'Maw and Janna up to the top side. And the Spell Thief's charges will mostly be used on a turret, it looks like.
Adrian tanking up the camp, going through potions. Kog'Maw takes the last hit, so shared XP right there. Quas and Dominate duo jungling on the greedy side of the map, but not punished for it. Likewise for the Impulse duo. The jungle top duo, rather. Dominate does get the full level 2 now from this. Phoenix versus Gate. Gonna be an interesting one. Phoenix already off to an early lead, but of course part of that is the jungle camp.
Yeah, gonna have to keep that in mind. There's a plus 3 for Phoenix.
And it's worth pointing out, Quas missed level 2. Did someone take like a part of the camp or something, because Quas, I thought he shared two camps here, but Dominate.
They've given it all over to Dominate.
All right. Well, he wasn't level 3 off his third camp, though, so something went awry. Thresh and Impact still duoing.
Interesting. So they are sending Xpecial up here to try and catch the wave from Apollo and Adrian with a two-man net. Xpecial does have his stun, but as you said, Quas also didn't hit level 2.
Ooh.
So he's sitting there at level 1 as well, and Lee Sin already going to head over here. Four men from Team Impulse on the top side of the map. They're already pinging the route. Blue buff into dive. Rush going to go mid, though. There is a ward from Phoenix. He's true.
Really smart.
Stays true to his word. Rush makes an early visit mid for Phoenix.
And it's a good ward by Phoenix as well. He knows that Lee Sin was the top side of the map. He had to be coming from red buff. Properly reveals the route, so good heads-up play by Phoenix to make sure that gank was not likely to happen. Quasic Special in the dual lane. It's going to be a weaker lane, though, and he can't really harass without fear of getting counterattacked. And Impact should be totally safe in a Gnar versus Sivir. I actually think this lane swap scenario favors Impulse's lanes.
Gnar should be able to get more last hits a lot easier as well. Maokai a bit more difficult to grab those with, trying to use your abilities. Impact doing fairly well for himself so far.
Phoenix is crushing right now. It's a 5 minion lead and a big health bar lead. Really nicely done by the Team Liquid mid laner here. He is the scariest one-on-one mid laner in the league. Gate still trying to fight him. Takes so much damage for that trade. That's a misstep, though. And Gate is now like one body slam flash away from dying.
He's just getting himself into bait territory here, Phreak. Ah, get himself nice and low. Bait. The gate bait. He's going to call Rush over.
Great.
All right. Calm down, mate.
Wait.
Rush does have flash. Trinket Ward is up as well, so he can make a ward hop play. At this point, though, Gate is so low, he can't even really help when Rush goes for the gank. So Phoenix could probably fend off a gank 2 versus 1 and be just fine.
Oh, dear.
He does just that.
All right, there's the recall. Gate accepts his fate, goes back to the base. He's going to buy, go for his first tier laser upgrade. Just has 1,000 gold for himself. Rush laughing it up in the mid lane.
Yeah, see how long he's laughing for. He's sitting down there on a half health bar, and Xpecial's moved up. Does he have a stun ready? Couldn't tell on the brush. I think he does. Yes, he does.
Ward hops away, flashes, but still going to land the body slam. In comes Phoenix, gets the first blood. Rush did not see it coming.
That mid lane I had my eye on already paying off for Team Liquid. Gate, the pressure from Phoenix was way too much for him. And eventually, it does cost Impulse a death mid. Rush being drawn out from the jungle, having to cover for Gate. And Team Liquid pounce on it.
And even Impact was drawn out there as well. He started a TP in case the dive failed. And now he's on that 3-minute cooldown on that spell. So that'll limit his lane assignments in the near future. Piglet?
Gate's play is causing Team Impulse other members to alter their normal play.
Whoa.
And both Rush and Impact losing out. Adrian here just going to take a decent chunk.
He was counting the stacks on Xpecial, knew he couldn't get stunned, and wanted to make sure he could stop recalls. Piglet is sitting on that BF sword money, so Adrian's just trying to delay that and find an advantageous lane matchup and Rush, deny experience in gold.
Rush has been seen by the wards here of Team Liquid, so they're going to be able to keep track of him really easily. Once you get him off the map for a second, they were able to get inside deep in the jungle, both sides.
Oh! Phoenix does not land the ulti. That would have been a kill on the Gate, I'm pretty sure.
Whoops. He had flash for it, too.
Yeah.
Gate does have flash and ghost available. But Phoenix unable to get either out. Decent amount of damage exchanged, though.
Mega Gnar. Minute and a half still on his teleport. He's up in the track for sure. We got the Sheen and the Longsword in for Apollo. If he can find the matchup, he could definitely win some trades here. Piglet finally gets away. Adrian cannot stop him. Piglet allowed to buy a good number of consumables. As Gate's having a really rough time. Down 10 CS, it's going to get worse. Phoenix can freeze this lane now and deny another 10 before Gate can get back.
Yeah, just Phoenix, with the amount of mid pressure he's been able to apply, he's actually taken away all of Impulse's playmaking ability. He draws the Lee Sin out of the jungle early game. Rush is a non-factor. They even bait out the teleport from Impact early game, also a non-factor. Those are the biggest playmaking positions on a team because their support is Janna. Low impact roams coming from him, so.
And how nice is it for IWillDominate to be on the champion that's not Lee Sin, has more gold, has had more early game impact, and is completely just outperformed Rush so far in that very small way.
Easy when your mid lane wins like that.
Of course, but that's the snowball. That's when you have the best mid laner in the league. And Gate on his second game here. Oh, Piglet misses the spell shoot on the hop. Impact is in on this one. He does have flash. Smite was used. Flash chase from Impact. Doesn't land the Q. With not enough damage, Rush had ward hopped, so he couldn't safeguard to his teammate. Couldn't get in range any farther.
Jukes there from Piglet, able to keep himself upright, but it does cost him all of his summoner spells and ultimate, so bottom side will be hurting. Pretty deep wards here from Impulse, too. And Impact's teleport just now coming off cooldown. If he hadn't had to use his teleport earlier in the mid lane, or if he, I don't know if he had to, but if he hadn't done it, he could have teleported there and cut off Piglet due to that deep ward in the side brush that's about to expire. So we're seeing the ramifications of that mid lane pressure manifest themselves 9 minutes in.
True statements. However, the farm still trading close enough to equal. Impulse only down 400 despite losing the first blood here. So the lanes are managing. Gate has all of his cooldowns up. He can walk away pretty cleanly. Down 18 CS in the mid lane, but answered back elsewhere on the map. Leads for both Apollo and for Impact here. As Rush looks for something to do, but cannot find his way into the top lane there. The Kog'Maw versus Maokai matchups. Not exactly a lot of gank assistance, so... You know, unfortunately, Impulse, as much as they're maybe picking champions they just like to play and they don't care as much about the team comps, there's really not a lot of good gank assistance in his lanes. So none of these Lee Sin ganks can do much.
Yeah, there's really nowhere he can go unless he tried to make something happen with Impact, as usual.
Jeez. Just takes poke for nothing. Gate still zoned out. Phoenix continuing his dominance. No fear. More damage. Here comes the attempt. But again, cannot land the Sonic Wave.
A bit of mana burned. That's it.
Not an impact. Okay. Decent damage. Good spell shield.
In comes Dominate, circling around back, but Rush smells blood in the water as well.
Dominate sees him, walks right out. Rush gets body slammed up. Actually, severe damage. Forced to ward hop away. He's going to get Xpecial. Perfect flash and a great explosive cast. Impact cannot finalize the kill. TP comes in from everybody else. Rush forced run away, but here comes Phoenix. That's his first kill, second kill of the game. Also won onto Adrian. Impact, the third casualty of the fight. 4-0. Piglet will go down. Finally, Gate finds something.
Oh, the Twisted Abyss!
This is the laser, and in comes the knockups. Beautifully played by Team Liquid. 5-1 in this game, and the turret.
Oh my goodness, that blows the game wide open for Team Liquid here. Big wave they can shove into the secondary turret as well. Yes, Apollo's by himself, but there's not much he can do up there. Just get some more farm.
So smart by Team Liquid. Not only did they go and gank the lane with Dragon, but they gank the lane where there's no teleport on the other side of the map. There's no chance for it to be an equal number. Fight for Impulse here.
Numbers advantage. They press it in here, and Xpecial, the flash. Dominate spreading everyone out, so Rush can't follow up and take down the low health support. And we see the split here. This is just easy pickings for Team Liquid. Gate does come in with the Ghost to try and pick up one here, but look at this Twisted Advance from Quas. Goes untargetable, dodges the laser with it, and Phoenix gonna flash back up and finish the job.
Gate didn't even pull his ulti in for the first 4 seconds too. He killed Piglet and just stood there. Small misplay, might not have made a difference in kills, but still a missed opportunity for Gate. 5-1, sizable gold lead now for Team Liquid, plus 2,000, 12 and a half minutes in here. Xpecial still trying to play the warding game. Boots of Moby are in, and a couple of deep wards into the jungle. Dominate also has a Sightstone, Rush as well. Waiting in the wings. Goes in, knocks him around, but where's the teammates at? He's getting jumped on. Gate tries to show, they do stun, and they do pick up the kill. Nice movements there by Impulse.
Rush able to pull a play out of nowhere. Going all in on Xpecial. He knew he didn't have flash from that last engage down bottom.
And Impact got his teleport canceled by Quas.
Ooh.
And just an easy W. 5 minute cooldown on that TP.
Dominate gonna try and secure this blue for Phoenix. They wait out the tornado.
Yep, smart. 2-0-1, plenty of items already through here for Phoenix. He's gotta feel great about this game. 20 minion lead right now over Gate. The manifest 800 gold, the two kills definitely nice. This Viktor stays zoned out of the lane. We actually see the 2-on-2 match back up with about similar gold.
Rush headed up to the top lane, wants to try and make something happen with the Kog'Maw Janna, which don't have much to set it up. It would have to be really a counter game with Team Liquid setting it. Right now, Team Liquid playing defensively though.
He's holding it in case there's a dive because Team Impulse trying to freeze that up there, and they expect Dominate to be around, but he's not. Dominate is stealing the blue buff away and says, hey guys, Rush is nowhere to be seen. This is just gonna be ours, and Impact also has to be a bit careful. No turret, and he's alone here. 1v2.
Phoenix is headed down as well. Impact
has
is
flash. Body slam first, an explosive cast. No, explosive cast first. Impact doesn't flash it. Nowhere to go. Kill picked up by Quas. And Rush spent all that time top lane for nothing.
Phoenix again with the earlier roam. Able to get there in time and cut off the exit. There was no hope for Impact, even if he had flashed. Gate does it, does shove one wave into the turret and clear a pink ward for his time spent, though.
This game just feels a little bit like Team Liquid's game yesterday. They're being opportunistic. If the advantage is there, they seize it. But they're just winning their lanes and slowly but surely winning the game. They've only knocked one turret down. But it's been farm and kills, putting it farther and farther ahead. Apollo wants this turret. He will get it. No kill comes through. So much weight right now is on Apollo's Kog'Maw, though. He's the only guy not tarnished by deaths. He's the only guy actually winning in CS in the game, actually. He's the highest in the game. So he's very far ahead. Trinity Force waiting to be completed.
Should be able to do that next back. Yeah.
He's the only man on his team winning in gold for his role. Everyone else on Team Liquid is doing better here. The eggs in the Apollo basket, no better champion for that than Kog'Maw. Again, he's got money for Triforce.
The ward hatches.
I wonder when Apollo will buy. No dragon for a while, so there's nothing to exactly power spike for. Still some defense from the Team Liquid duo lane.
Yeah, they're not that far behind.
No, of course not.
They are losing.
But Piglet bought. Piglet's got a better inventory.
True. Rush gonna try and head in here through the fog more. Sneaks his way up. Maokai's pretty difficult to take down this close to a turret, though. It would have to be sort of a counter gank situation where Costco's really aggressive with his dominate coming, but Rush keeps on getting into these positions where they think there's gonna be a play from dominate. And Dominate, being the passive farm jungler, is focused on a lot of these neutral camps and getting down vision instead. So Rush unable to capitalize.
There we go.
And all the while, Phoenix just keeps on bullying mid lane.
Yeah. And Dominate got the wards down to track the movements of Rush. He was sure that this
teleport up top, they're gonna make a dive here.
Here comes the attempt, then Dominate's up. Xpecial gonna land the stun. Oh, he only gets Rush, but goodbye to the Lee Sin. Nice knockback by Adrian, buys some time, but Phoenix is here. The knockback into the wall, they've got nowhere to go. A quick three kills picked up with that one. Gate can't do enough on the return. Team Liquid, a very well executed dive. Phoenix walks away with his life. 9-2 in this game.
Another clean sweep here for Team Liquid. Three kills and the objective. Well, they only have to trade off their bottom turret for it. Impulse continue to lick their wounds. Gate, again, the last arrival to the fight. Teleport goes off. Phoenix already on his way up. And Xpecial flashes in to ensure the double stun there. But Apollo already out of... Double knock up there onto the wall. Nowhere for him to go. He gets stuck between a sand soldier and the wall.
Right, Team Impulse, though, happen to have the right position to go for a dragon here. So, good fight or not, at least an objective comes through. Impulse can breathe a bit easy. The game at a 3,500 gold advantage, definitely a big one, but not the craziest, honestly, relative to the leads we've been seeing this game. But it is one that's not insurmountable. Zerk Greaves and Triforce done for the Kog'Maw. He didn't have that for the last fight. Maybe it gets a bit better. Impulse still just built around putting up the shields, putting up the defense, keeping him alive. Xpecial gets caught out. Jumped off the wall by Rush. Well done. A second kill into this Kog'Maw.
There's a play for you from Team Impulse. Rush able to make something happen here. Apollo over the wall. That's where they want their money, so try and funnel as much as they can into him. But aside from stray picks and picking up, you know, a kill bounty, it's about all Impulse are able to grab for themselves. They don't have too many options to make plays with. Impact on this teleport would have to come up huge for the team. He has just spiked on level 11 to get level 2 ultimate. Maybe he can charge up Gnar bar and try and make something happen for the team. But otherwise, Team Liquid are looking really solid right now. They also have Sivir ultimate to rely upon if they do get caught out. Dominate on the Gragas always, ready with the disengage.
Yeah. Team Liquid's advantages are really all on Dominate and Phoenix. Quas is actually behind in gold under impact. So that minion lead can allow still some room for playmaking. You mentioned the level 11 Gnar here. But mid lane under fire, down to 1/3 health, just getting crushed out. Piglet shows up, ulti to buy some time, but Gate will not do enough damage to matter. Apollo on the chase, wants to kill Phoenix, slowed down by a barrel, explosive cast by his time impact. Knocked in, forced to flash out, Quas the front line. Re-engage comes across, three big kills picked up off the Maokai. Ulti a kickback by Rush, turns one around, but he's got no friends left around. Another kill picked up off the Maokai, and Apollo's gone. 4-for-1
That's
going to
be inhibitor,
Liquid. Freak.
They're going to push straight in.
20-minute inhibitor. Phoenix is so far ahead. Dominate made the ganks count. He's been part of 12 of his team's 13 kills. Team Liquid, if they win this game, they get a first-round bye in the playoffs. And they're poised to make that happen.
Oh, man, is he okay? We need a second reaction cam there. I feel like that's what just happened to team. He's fine. Yeah, there we go. He's fine. That's what just happened to Impulse there. They were trying to get in the spotlight, and Dominate just came barreling through. The ultimate splits the team perfectly for the re-engage here. So Team Liquid able to use the Sivir speed boost to disengage and buy time for Quas. Once Quas arrives here and Dominate with the great barrel isolating impact. Easy re-engage. Here goes Xpecial, stunning up three key members. We did give him flack for missing some of those anti-stuns previously in the week, but yeah, that was a great one from Xpecial. Credit where credit is due. And they pull off the turnaround.
They tried again for Dominate, but a body slam kept them from getting jumped around on. All is well still for the Team Liquid fans here. 6,000 gold lead. Mid-turret revived once more for Phoenix. Down the line, you've got pretty good score lines for the Team Liquid members here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
Yeah. Second blue steal in a row.
Complete control here from Team Liquid. Even this move over to Baron here is just a clear out vision for Impulse.
Out of vision to clear.
Because Team Liquid can't do it fairly quickly now. The death cap completed already on Phoenix. Hitting the death cap Morel and Nomicon spike at 22 minutes in from Phoenix.
Yeah. He is the richest member in the game at 9,000 gold flat right now. Got to feel good about this one. Team Liquid looking to ascend here late in the playoffs. They are the third place playoff team of the spring split after a very late surge by Phoenix and Piglet. They've been playing at that level all split long, looking to tie Counter Logic Gaming for first. Like, how long has it been since former Curse and CLG were the top two teams in North America? But that's what it's looking like right now.
Never.
Yeah. To be fair, it's been since never.
It's been never, Freak.
Man. A CLG team. I mean, I'm going in the future here, but like a CLG Team Liquid final. Like, that is how the NA landscape has shaped up over time. It'll at least be the first place bout in the regular season.
Ooh, Apollo going to come over and try and check with some artillery. Make some damage from Baron there, and everybody gets out.
One hit on Phoenix, one hit. Oh, here comes the TP flank. Gates caught out. Gates going down. Goodbye.
Don't even need the home guard teleport. Maokai coming in. They finish him off before Quas can get an assist. Adrian pops the Janna ultimate, though. That should be easy inhibitor. They can probably draw back to the Baron pit as well, since they have full true sight over it. Yeah. Currently, we do have impact split pushing for Impulse, so they're trying to get something back, but he's gonna have to start worrying about his own safety fairly soon here as Team Liquid retreat, and there is absolutely no vision from Team Impulse out on this map.
And the unfortunate thing for Impulse here is I know this comp is built around this Kog'Maw, which is why you're seeing like the full tank Gnar, just seeing the barely tanky Lee Sin as opposed to the AP Evelynn. But full tank Gnar does not split push well. He doesn't even really knock down Quas easily, so his threat on the side of the map can be safely ignored by Team Liquid. They knock down a dragon for themselves. They're second now, so they kill turrets faster. A nice thing for this team. And Impulse continue to try to control Baron. They are only down this, you know, 5,500. That's actually, it's kind of a lot now at this point. I was going to say only, but no, that's actually a pretty sizable lead here. Team Liquid very well in control.
They're pretty far in control here.
Yeah. If it was like 2K, I'd be like, oh, it's still a chance. You know, one good fight, you're all right. But yeah, 5K, hard to get through, and especially with how hard it's been for Team Impulse to get picks. They get maybe one guy at a time occasionally when someone gets caught warding, but nothing happens afterwards. Impulse knocked one turret down in the lane swap game, essentially, and won a while later off of Kog'Maw again.
Also, this Viktor here at the mid range, there's nobody he should be able to kill. Maybe if they catch Xpecial out in a misposition, then they can kill. He can kill Xpecial. But other than that, this Viktor too far behind to really do much to either of the members of the frontline for Team Liquid.
Yeah.
And the frontline is so dangerous that it's really hard for him to even get in position to try and get a laser to the backline. So
yeah, they're even so tanky, his Abyssal doesn't do much against them.
Super hard for Gate to even play a team fight now.
Yeah.
Same for Rush. Looking for a miracle steel heal for him here for himself, though.
There we go. Baron attempted. This is maybe the comeback attempt for Impulse. They don't take much damage on Baron, but maybe Rush gets the steal. Dominate ult's gonna come in a second. No, they disengage it. They send people around the wall. Adrian buys a bit of time. Phoenix to do some damage. Won't get the knockback here. They go in an Xpecial. Xpecial goes down. A great bait by Gate, and here comes the push on in. Into the back line goes Phoenix, a flash away from Gate, and he's still alive here. Quas taking up the front line. Roots Apollo. His cog was in a bad spot. Pushed back by the Emperor's Divide. Impact, though, inside the team. Lands the Gnar ulti, but not enough damage. There's the gold lead at work here. It's a 2-for-1 in favor of Team Liquid. They will catch up Apollo with a barrel. The slow is there. The slow from Phoenix. The kill comes through, a 3-for-1 off the Baron attempt. And that fight goes properly. Team Liquid get farther and farther ahead.
Yep, they're going to retreat back to Baron now and finish the job as well. Phoenix should be able to take care of this one fairly quickly. Ooh, early smite here just to get it down even faster. That would open up for nothing. Nobody can get there in time.
Rush walks over and says, "Pia!" Oh, never mind.
He doesn't even. Back to ward clearing duty. That's all they've been able to do around this Baron pit. Sivir boosted Annie, flashes in to get them.
Split call, though.
Does sacrifice his life, but he's able to ensure the engage and the team fight. Team Liquid able to follow up due to the speed there from Sivir. And Phoenix cuts off. If Apollo and Gay had any idea, they don't even have any mana, so not much they can do from outside the soldiers. And Liquid clean him up.
Yeah, the really unfortunate thing, Impulse running out of mana in that fight, definitely hurt their chances of hitting a couple more cooldowns. If Gate had mana, if Gate had another item, I think that fight could have turned, because it was a split engage by Team Liquid, a sloppy one, but the stats pulled it through.
Now the Baron buff, they're just going to easily knock down turrets. Got to watch out for one of these Gragas ultimates on the turret.
Team Liquid's win will give us the max number of tiebreakers yet allowed in our schedule. Give us 3. Battle for first, battle for third, battle for seventh. Team Liquid do not look like they're going to give this game away. Baron Nashor on the team. Two inhibitors already down. Team Liquid to secure a first round bye in the playoffs to have a tiebreak with CLG for the best team in the regular season. And you figure with their third place finish at the spring split, and a guaranteed top 4 finish here, Team Liquid have so many opportunities to qualify for their first ever trip to the World Championship. Some of the players have been there before, but this team has never. Team Liquid have a lot of opportunities. One final recall. Mop up the minions. They can make it a 13-win regular season for themselves.
Yep.
Piglet joins Quas for the final inhibitor kill. Tier 2 turret should be nearly impossible to stop. These guys don't care about Dragon. It comes up in a minute, but they've got a Baron to use. They've got inhibitor deaths to use. Impulse sweep away with some waves. Top tier 2 is going to go down.
Yep. This one will be very, very easy. They can actually also split and have somebody Baron empower minions towards mid and the exposed inhibitor. They're just going to brute force, run it straight in here and take out the last tower. Ooh, three hits on it. Phoenix absolutely demolishes this turret. And still, Rush waiting on the outside, looking to make a play on Lee Sin. Always eyes for opportunity here. Unable to find anything, and it looks like it's going to close in on Team Impulse now.
Last chance to fight, but the turret's already gone. Gate just gets exploded. One for nothing so far. Phoenix buys some time. Piglet still goes down. A one for one. A big Gnar ulti. Maybe the comeback fight happens. Multiple kills coming through for Impulse. Apollo's still alive. There's only tanks left. Lee Sin lands the Q, but Rush maybe doesn't want it. No, he's going to keep going. Dominate, going to fire back for some damage. A final kill comes through. That's an ace for Impulse. They're keeping the hope alive.
An ace for one. Only gate goes down, and they can snag a dragon off the back of it. It's only dragon number two, but it's something, Freak.
Yeah, the inhibitors are coming back up. The teleport's available for impact in a second. They can clear up a lot of this map. Mid lane outer turret can finally go down. A bunch of gold given over. They may even stay for mid tier two. Kog'Maw's getting the dead inhibitor farm in the base.
The opportunities for Team Liquid, they looks like they reach a little too far. They look past the end of the game here. Everybody rushing in, not bothering to go mid for the exposed inhibitor, trying to crush through the turret. Piglet running straight into the front line there.
Yeah.
On Sivir.
I mean, at least they fight after the turret dies.
Everybody, Phoenix and Piglet, the two damage sources, stand right next to each other for Team Liquid. It looks like they got very careless here. Apollo takes him out one versus one, and then impact with a huge Gnar ultimate. Game changer right there. At the very least, the team fight changer. Rush keeps tabs of Dominant, so they're going to be able to get the full ace here. But they weren't able to actually collapse on the dragon. They opted for the gold for, instead, which is a much better choice. If you can only get one and you have to make the choice between the two, definitely go for the turret and the gold first.
Impulse have no use for Dragon 2, and the mini waves are not a good enough spot to go for it. They do allow Team Liquid to get the movement speed, so I'm just agreeing with you pointing out the details of the situation. Impact still getting some farm. 252 minions. He's almost 100 up over Quas. Quas has been sort of forced to be a utility for his team, be around the Sivir, get ready to ult on in, but it's allowed Impact to be gigantic now. 2, 4, and 6, 11,000 gold. He is 1,000 over Quas as an individual.
Xpecial gonna find Rush though.
It's gonna be a bit dangerous. He can always jump over the wall and whatnot. Misses the Q, but Impact wants it. Great spell shield by Piglet, and Rush is gonna be taking so much damage. Still kills Xpecial. Dominates time of the gravity field. Rush running away,
Quas!
But he pulls in Quas. Kill goes to Piglet. A lot of damage to the back line though. The Chaos Storm churning on towards Quas and company. It's a one for one. In comes Phoenix. He doesn't yet go down. He finally trades his life, but it's still a one for one. Impact taking up in the back lines. Still hasn't died, but Apollo's gone. Gate's still up somehow. Impact kiting away from Dominate. Oh my god! Another ace for Impulse.
Phoenix went for the all-in play on Azir, and Gate was able to snipe him on the last auto attack there. Barely able to finish him off. As he tries to escape it, Impulse come up with another huge teamfight turnaround here. Their base is in shambles, but they're coming back.
Wow, from being down 50 minions and being 1-2, Gate. Now 5-4-5, the consistent teamfight presence is there. And it seems like Team Liquid just cannot knock down enough of the damage threats. They kill Gate, Apollo kills them all. They kill Apollo, Gate kills them all.
So once again, Rush actually creating a play by getting caught here. Even though he misses that Q, Impact has Mega Gnar, the last seconds of Mega Gnar he uses to flash in and secure the first kill. Quas' teleport finishes just in time to channel. I thought that was going to be a game changer there for Team Liquid because he got to follow Rush into the team. But everyone else got chunked so hard, the backline here. And Phoenix makes this play without having completed Azonias. Gate walks up just on the outside of those sand shoulders to get his auto off and finish off Azir. Then we have a couple of micro outplays here as Impact is able to kite dominate long enough for Boomerang to come back.
And full tank Gnar, like, good luck killing that champion as Sivir, by the way. If Phoenix dies, no one kills Impact anymore. It's a two-threat team, and he's itemized to not die to Piglet. Phoenix really needs that defensive stats, and it might even be not a Zonya's next. That NL Rod could mean almost anything.
Baron call has been made. And Impact is bottom, does have teleport. He's charging up his bar now. There's another catch. Good disengage from Janna.
Now he's going to use TP in.
They got the teleport cooldown. That's pretty big for Team Liquid. They needed to equalize.
Oh, he's going to go in. He finds Rush, but
DPS
very alone. He gets soloed out, and that's going to be Quas going down on a very poor choice of play. 4v5 now for a lot of time. Team Liquid forced to run.
Rush just makes the huge bait plays back to back. This time he channels Quas into the team over the wall. Perfect timing there for him. And they circle around, five members able to DPS down the tank.
The gold's tied here, and it's a 5v4. I don't think Team Liquid has much opportunity here to make this happen. Sivir ulti is up. Xpecial's flash is up. The engage potential's here in a 4v5, but it's got to be tight. Half health onto Baron.
Oh,
Dominate
my.
Could steal. This is a risky choice for Impulse. Rush at half.
Flash
Impact
from Xpecial.
Flash stun gets to the backliners, but the front line reconverges. The split's okay for the Baron doing damage, but it's fine. Impact in the back line. Phoenix goes down. Two more kills picked up. This is a great thing as Dominate's going to go down.
They're going to do
Impulse
it.
Win another fight. They're third in a row. Baron's theirs. Impulse want that first round bye.
Baron empowered recalls. They won't lose anything for this either.
Wow. Team Liquid knocked down all but one turret of the Team Impulse base. All the inhibs are open. The Nexus has only one turret left. All Liquid needed was one good team fight, and they win the game. And three times in a row now, Impulse outplays them.
They got a little lazy up at that last inhibitor turret. And Impulse do not go down without a fight. They continue swinging back to back to back teamfight victories for Impulse.
Wow.
And they're taking back the map. Let's take another look at it here. Phoenix on the outside has set up a sand soldier, so Xpecial flashes in. Doesn't get Apollo in it though. He got Gate and Adrian, but Apollo free firing here, and Phoenix just gets destroyed.
It's the difference in builds. Gate went for an Abyssal Scepter and tried to be a bit tanky. He's got the shield from his Q. Phoenix, full squishy. No magic in his build whatsoever. And that means...
And he's got a null magic mantle.
All right, now he's got it. Yeah, great. At 40 minutes. And an Aegis on his team, but that means he's getting bursted out. And that's the problem is Team Impulse actually able to find the burst from Gate. He lost his lane. But Gate is absolutely crushing team fights now. Impulse, the team that says, we just want to play our game. We don't care if we lose as long as we do what we want to do. We're going to play aggressive. We're going to play impulsive. 5,000 gold deficit, willing to fight, willing to get those battles to work.
And Rush constantly trying to make plays for the team.
And the only guys building damage are the new guy in Gate and Apollo. The most improved AD carry of the year. Dragon goes over, the second for Impulse. They get bonus turret damage here. Team Liquid now down 4,500. They've got to dig deep and find that comeback play. Get the pick, there's no Zonyas in the mid lane. There's always the chance that engage lands and Azir one-shots your team. They're gonna have to find that comeback though. If Team Liquid do lose this game, there will not be a tiebreaker with Gravity. The head-to-head is owned by Team Gravity, and that will be a fourth place finish for Team Liquid. They'll have to work up through the playoffs that way. They would face Team Solo mid first round.
We're not done yet, though.
Of course not. I started talking about playoff positions last time, and then won three fights in a row.
All right, Team Liquid now into recovery mode. Yeah, look at that. Almost spiking up to 10k the lead. And a huge drop off ever since that inhibitor turret dive.
Yep.
That will haunt them for a while.
Piglet fought up against the wall and got picked off by Kog'Maw and Gnar. They thought the lead was too big for those fights to get lost, and you saw it right there.
That being said, their base is so fragile right now for Impulse. If they ever get caught out of position and start to lose members,
yeah,
Team Liquid can take everything from them.
If you look at our one team fight for winning the game despite the previous missteps, Impulse still have a lot of structures to work through.
They haven't shown that they can win one of those team fights, though.
Very true.
Impact has been just massive for the team. Clutch Gnar ultimates coming up.
Spectre's Cowl for Phoenix. He should no longer get one shot by Viktor here.
Working towards the Banshees, I assume. Try and block one of those spells.
He may stop the Cowl and go Zonius. I feel like Liquid needs damage.
It's a possibility.
I feel like they really, really need the damage. Apollo starting his fourth item here. Offensive item, I should say. Quick Service Sash already done, of course. Plenty of auto-attack damage here. Adrian does get Ardent Sensor for himself. He got that after Ascension, after Mikhail's. And now his shields and ultis will give plenty of power over to Apollo. Make him even scarier here in this Kog'Maw.
Remember, it's all about who gets the initiative in the team fight now. Because these members are still squishy. Gate can easily be taken out. If he is dropped before one of these team fights with a Sivir speed boost, or a Maokai home guard teleport. Whoa!
Maybe it's gonna be Rush.
Piglet face to face with Rush.
Yeah, one risk is that Impulse don't have good team fights starting. Right? They don't have the move speed buffs, really. They don't have the engaged champions, at least not the reliable ones. They rely on Gnar's passive. They rely on Rush for the kickback. Those are all difficult to do.
They really would rather, it seems like, control the neutral objective right now. Because they control the team fight, they control the map out in the open. So they just need to get one of those outer ring of wards down and wait for this Baron. 1:40 on the Baron.
And they've done that so well. If you look at the vision there, Team Impulse sees so much of the Baron area, and Team Liquid see basically nothing.
Oh, Piglet sees Gate.
They're looking for Gate. He's going to run towards his team, but there's no one around. There's the flashes in. There's the stun. They got him. He's gone.
Just what we cautioned against. Team Liquid see Gate on the open, and they burn him down. Now how many inhibitors can they take?
4v5, only one damage dealer. There are no turrets up for the inhibs.
Oh,
50
man.
Seconds, a minion wave coming in, and just as Team Liquid were losing the game, they find the pick they need. Impulse, what are they willing to fight for? Turret number one, or inhib number one, given away. Inhib number two, they're gonna let it happen. Dominate does not have an ulti. There's a bit more safety from these guys to not get caught.
30 seconds left. Three inhibitors down is a death sentence.
Liquid don't have to feel scared about this top inhibitor.
They need to do it before Gate gets back up. 20 seconds left on it. Impact's Mega Gnar runs out. That should be third inhibitor. It's almost gone.
There's the push on in. Third inhib should give map control away. How do you stop a dragon or a baron with three inhibitors dead in your base? Rush wants in. He's got to be a bit careful. Gate's alive in 1 second. He's got home guard. Here he comes. Here's the push. Impulse, what can he do? Piglet's ulti is down for 2 more seconds. The knockup on a dominate Piglet.
Dominate
running away. There's the kill picked up. It's a 5v4 back for Impulse. Piglet dodges the boomerang. He's on the run. Sivir ulti lets his team.
They can't chase for too long. Impulse have to recover with these minions. They're all at the Nexus turret here. They only have a single Nexus turret left.
Well, Baron's up in 3 seconds. Impulse going to use the 5v4 to look for a neutral objective, I think, and use that to keep their base alive.
Team Liquid just need to delay then, because the minion wave is gigantic down bottom. Gate's going to try and handle it.
This is risky. Gate's going to be the one defending, so it's a 4v4 that Team Liquid know about. They know Gate must defend. His wave clear's good. He'll get tons of money here, but Impulse won't get a thing off of this.
Apollo just stole blue, so he grabs something for himself. That's actually pretty big.
They try again for Dragon, sorry, again for Baron. Piglet's in base. This is a 3v4. This should be easy enough for Impulse. Quas and Phoenix, they couldn't possibly steal this, but maybe they get the fight. Impact is tanky, though. He buys the time. No steal coming through. There's Baron Nashor and all 5 members of Impulse for 3 minutes, which will overlap with the inhibitor response.
Freak, what is this game?
This is Team Impulse and Team Liquid fighting for the first round. Bye. This is, I think, the closest game of the split for sure here. The stakes are high, and Team Impulse fought from a massive deficit, then nearly threw it away. and they're going to gain so much money. They're up 8,000 gold already and get to farm 3 inhibitor deaths.
Well, do you get to farm stacked up super minions, Phreak? That's a really big force to deal with. Even if you have Baron buff, Team Liquid can come up and continue the pressure.
Yeah.
Impact having a hard time himself dealing with it, and they're doing just that. 3 inhibitors down, it's still hard to come back from. The single Nexus turret is the only thing they have left standing between Team Liquid and victory.
And Team Liquid can fight this risk-free. There is no chance that...
They're trying to clear him out.
I don't think Impulse could ever kill Liquid's base with the lanes
Dragon
in this kind
number
of
4
situation.
Will be free.
Yeah.
As free as anything ever is in League of Legends.
So I wonder what Liquid choose to give away. Level 18 on every single member of Team Impulse. Quas, Xpecial, Dominate. Still to hit 18.
In.
Massive level lead for Impulse here. They've got Baron buff, but there are minions on the side of Team Liquid. One turret stands between Team Liquid and the Nexus. Impact has Mega Gnar.
Defense of the Alamo commences for Impulse. Team Liquid really need to work around the Mega Gnar. Impact's game-changing ultimates have been what has turned it around previously for Impulse.
And
they're waiting
builds.
It out now.
Full builds for almost everyone here. Baron buff timing out in 1 minute. That'll roughly coincide with bot inhibitor being back up.
They're just gonna try and knock the inhibitors right back down as soon as they come up.
You can see the little red ring on the inhibitors show you the timer of how long till they respawn. They're still filling up though.
Keeping up that pressure.
The crystal starting to form. Inhib is pretty soon. Team Liquid still looking for the seeds. They cannot get into the Nexus though. The wave clear is good enough here. From Viktor and company. It's about to reach the turret line, but Impulse still defending quickly enough. Impact once again reaches Mega Gnar. Big damage comes in.
Oh, he's right on Phoenix! He puts him in! There's the fight! Phoenix goes down! 5v4, here comes the battle. Quas locked up in the front line, and in comes Quas for Impact. Rush in the back line as well. Zones out Piglet. It's a double kill for Impact. They're gonna crush the Team Liquid line, but how much can Impulse even get? They're still stuck in their base.
How many times can he do it? Impact, are you kidding me? He's gonna drag Gate kicking and screaming across the finish line here. Oh my goodness.
And there's the Dragon 4. Team Liquid thought they had wanted a siege instead of picking up this Dragon. I'm not sure if it was the right choice because they could have been on the path to Dragon 5 a bit sooner and literally just play the Dragon inhibitor game forever.
They wanted that victory. They wanted the consecutive inhibitor kills. They wanted to keep up the pressure to try and knock him down, but Impact takes the tiny window. If he was 20 seconds later,
yeah,
the things would be down. He would have knocked down all the inhibitors. They had a very, very small window there. And Phoenix, hubris cost him his life.
And instead of pushing the inhibitor, he pushed
Team Liquid the final push. He flashes as well. He's gonna have to be even more careful. Huge punish there from Impact, but Phoenix presenting that opportunity also definitely going to hear about that one.
So Rush switched over to being a full tank. Cinderhulk in for him with the Chilling Smite. So you have a 306 armor, 3,800 health Gnar, and a 4,500 health, 266 armor Lee Sin. Piglet's not going to kill these guys.
Rush is going for another play here.
He's not going to die much, though. Looks for the kick. Finds Xpecial, buys a bit of time. Here's Mega Gnar. Here's the next attempt for Impact, but Rush down to half, taking a lot of pain for this one. They stun up Dominate, though. Big damage in from Kog'Maw, and that'll be the kill, but they're going to answer back out of Rush. Both junglers are dead, and the fight continues. The
gravity
field stuns up Quas. Impact takes a lot of damage for that one, though. All three inhibs back up. Nothing much to play for.
Rush a little bit greedy going back in there. I feel like Apollo and Gate could have finished off that kill without the assistance of the full tank Lee Sin, who has swapped over to Cinderhulk in the late game, by the way, giving up that warrior from the early game.
Whew. What's crazy is right now there's actually a massive item lead for Team Impulse. You can see they've all got too much money to spend anymore. Fully upgraded trinkets, filled out item slots. Only Adrian can buy a Banshee's Veil here, but not a single person on Team Liquid is maxed out on money. Piglet still has a boot to enchant, or a boot to sell, or a trinket to upgrade, whereas Impulse are rolling in money. Over time, this actually means Liquid catches up in power. I mentioned in the last fight, they're still catching up in levels. We still have Quas not 18, Dom not 18, Xpecial not 18. There's actually a ton of resources that Impulse are able to use to win these fights.
Not only do they have the complete base still up as well, but they can erect towers all over Impulse territory here. Phoenix decides to go with the mid lane this time around to set up their outpost. Baron 1 minute, 17 seconds away, and they're going to try and use this mid point of control with the Azir turret to control vision around that Baron and make another play. Gate and Apollo have to separate themselves, as do Piglet and Phoenix. Very important in these late game team fights, positioning your threats on the opposite sides so that they cannot get comboed, whether it be from a Gnar ultimate or an Annie Flash Tibbers.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Gate bursts for about 2,300 damage on his full combo here.
Is that that's not counting magic resist?
Yes,
though.
That's before resist. Yeah. So you know, Void Staff and Abyssal help a little bit. You can see why there's three Spectre's Cowls and a Banshee's Veil or two on the Team Liquid lineup. Gate has absolutely become a menace. This is a guy who had gotten wrecked in his lane. Phoenix did so well in the matchup, but Gate was able to get his farm, able to catch up in the team fights, and he's made some big plays here. Distortion boots on him means he can go for the flash ulties and catch people out. Piglet has to be careful. And here we are, Baron up in 6 seconds. Impulse and Team Liquid. These fights are neck and neck, the kills one apart. And Liquid are on Dragon 4 right now, keep in mind.
They don't have to be the ones to start the Baron. They just have to keep vision. Working around Megadar once again.
Dragon's up in 2 minutes. Impulse's base still only has one turret inside it. A Team Liquid teamfight win ends the game. Team Impulse.
Depends on how much they win that teamfight by.
Yeah, an ace wins the game, I suppose. Outright. He's blocking the base and it dies. Dominate on the flank. They come with the TP in as well. Here comes Quas with the home guard. Who is he going to find?
They fail to punish the Gnar Rage Bar. Impact now will be able to charge it back up.
Oh, but Team Liquid have the inside track on the mid lane. They can go for the inhibitors yet again. And Team Impulse can't exactly dive into the squad.
Spell shield down on Phoenix. Flash back up, though.
Impact,
he's got flash barrier.
Out. They go through the base gate. This is going to be a dead inhibitor pretty fast.
Rush is coming up
away.
Behind them, though. Rush is
oh,
making a play.
He wants Piglet's Bell Shield used, but that means he doesn't have it for the kickback.
He scares him off the inhibitor, though.
Liquid forced to run. Dragon's up in a minute. That would be the fifth for Team Liquid. If they had gotten it last time around before the base trade, it would be up for them to use to knock this game down. A 14,000 gold deficit doesn't feel like it, though, for Team Liquid.
There are so many ifs, though. I mean,
of course there are.
The plan could have worked out. Skipping that fourth dragon and press and just knocking down all the inhibitors would have meant the game over right there without having to wait for multiple dragons.
Yeah.
It all comes down to this team fight, though. Impact
Talisman
once again.
Used. They once again slow down Dominate. Impact, though, is tired. He cannot get the Mega Gnar just yet. Once again, Phoenix buys the time. Impulse want to set up Baron, but Team Liquid just say, hey, your base is easy to kill.
Fresh
Piglet
goes for the home guards instead of coming behind them. Side waves, by the way, for Impulse are crushing it.
Ooh.
Side waves closing the timeline here for Team Liquid. Their window of opportunity is closing. Impact is on the chase.
Doing a lot of damage. He'll be Mega Gnar pretty soon. He's already at 2/3 of the bar. Really wants in on this one. The team's coming around. Phoenix forced to run for this one. Only half mana on that champion as well. Rush in from the side. Does have flash. Does have the ulti. There's the minions in the bot side. Of course, if Impulse win the fight, they can take the bot lane to win the game here. Dragon's up, and Impulse got the inside track here. Dominate could steal for Dragon 5, but losing his life for it would not be worth it here.
Team Impulse don't even need to do this dragon. Gnar is starving right now.
There we go. He's back down to small, though. Quas at half HP, forced to run. Down to 1,000 health. Rush still wants in. Q lands on Dominate. Impact back to Mini Gnar. Half health on the tank.
Impact actually made great use of the Mini Gnar form in the hyper and actually getting a lot of percentage damage on Quas.
Careful, though, for Impulse. There are two frontliners at half HP. They were itemizing armor more than magic resist, so Phoenix is still chunking these guys out. But low mana regen. TP home guard in for Impact. He still wants more. He's going to find Xpecial for a slow. Rush gets him too. Not going to go with the kick flash just yet. Rush nearly goes down. He's going to get found by Piglet, but stays alive. There goes Gate. He wants the AD carry. He's going to try to reach it. Phoenix puts up the turret. Piglet goes down. Phoenix is going to be next. Can they land the damage?
Impact's
He's
going to
run away. Impact is still trying. It's a 5v4, and the slow burn is coming through. Can't land the skills just yet, though. Minions push down the top lane inhibitor turret. There's actually Minions winning the game. Xpecial goes down to Gate. Impact still on the chase. Gate trying to run through Quas and Dom. There's kills all over the place. And three kills for Impulse. Will
able to trade it back. Gate goes down. Apollo's out of mana and out of health. He can't help Rush here. What's he sticking around for?
And Rush dies.
Apollo's going to go down. Here comes Impact on the way out to save the day.
Quas wants him, but so does Impact. He's going to find Apollo.
QSS now.
He got him.
The Azir turret hit him. Are you serious?
Azir gets a kill posthumously, and it means a team goes down. Win.
The minions are still doing work as
well.
Oh,
my God.
The base is under attack.
It might get cleared by Quas, but it's going to be close. Dominic comes back in. He's got the wave clear. We got to wait for respawns, Kobe. We got to wait.
Italia, it depends on how much you win that team fight by.
It's going down to minions.
Oh, no.
The minions.
Oh, no. That means so much map control now. Team Impulse are going to respawn about the same time. Piglet and Xpecial are up first. Keep in mind, the Team Impulse die. Deaths were late. Apollo, Gate, and Rush are dead for 20 seconds. Team Liquid can 4v2 the Baron.
They have a power play. They should be able to get Baron. Impact going to try and make something for himself. But Team Liquid are all on their way over to Baron. They're going to burn it down. Impact, he's going to have to make a hero play here to try and stall it. Rush is on the way. 10 seconds. He's got right. Home Guard. Right now, it's only Adrian
they
coming
need to
over.
Buy Home Guards and swap back. Gate doesn't do it, though. He stays with the Distortion, though. He's got the money to make the trade. Didn't see that one coming.
Impact does transform. They're going to give up this Baron. They got to give it up now. There's no way that Lee Sin can get there. They need to get their vision up. Impact, Don't risk your life for it.
Okay. Dominate smites it.
It was a good throw, good attempt there from Impact. The house does not pull off the steal, but Team Liquid now, one inhibitor down, do have the Baron buff up.
Here we go, guys. Red buff available. They gotta give that one to the Kog'Maw. Apollo, completely full build here. I think it needs to keep boots for the kiting power. We are on max item Kog'Maw, max power Kog.
This team fight, Freak.
Means everything.
I don't think I can watch.
That's fine, I'll do it.
Whew.
You gotta talk during fights, Kobe. Still at 10,000 goldy, but it pretty much means nothing. The only man not level 18 now is Xpecial, who's got teammates with close to full builds. Still room to go for the two tanks.
So here's the thing. Impulse want to make a move before the large group of Baron and Power minions move up. They don't want Team Liquid to be able to use that to wear down the inhibitors. They want to strike before they get inside the base. Rush is in position.
He wants to flank.
He also has true sight.
They
he knows they
the
don't
minions.
See him.
He can't let the minions turn him down, though. The Gate. Siege is too good.
They're clearing him. They propped his Raptor buff. True
ward.
Sight down.
Impact is Meganar. This would be the time. Talisman Ascension. Not used. They don't go in just yet.
The three soldiers standing for Phoenix, holding the line for Team Liquid. The inhibitor's going to go down here in a few attacks. Piglet can't get inside the range, though.
He's got to be afraid of Rush and Impact. Meninar comes through. That's going to be the time for Impulse to have a chance. Team Liquid.
Rush can't get through. Quas blocks him, playing
Pinchy's
the line,
down
man.
And Piglet.
This inhibitor's
the inhibitor.
Down.
There
that
we go.
One's toast.
Baron times out in a minute. That's only equal in his, by the way. Top lane is a massive wave. A massive inhibitor dead wave from the top side.
Baron
to get out
all these range minions. This is going to do it as well. Impulse did not pull the trigger. They lose two inhibitors.
They need to wait for Meganar. Impact still getting the stats in. A massive wave in the top lane, though, that has to pull Liquid's attention. If Team Impulse can close the gates, I think minions win the game.
Impact
they go with a kick.
It.
A great stun. They stop Rush. 2,000 health on him. They knock back Quas. He's low as well. Impact
oh,
is Meganar.
Out, though.
What can he find? In the base, though, a big wave. It's going to knock down at least one turret, I'm pretty sure.
That buys him the reprieve they need.
Recalls come through.
Team Liquid get two inhibitors without giving up anything else.
And Baron is going to come back first. Now the Baron buff is going to be gone.
They had to lock down that kill on Quas. That kick out to safety cost them everything. The Azir turret there holding the line for Team Liquid, and Impulse were unable to chase out. Dragon number 5, 30 seconds away. Impulse
are able to push in mid and bot first, though. Top lane actually still is spawning super minions, so stuff on other sides of the map. Impulse could even go for the hero play of pressuring top four Dragon and risking a base race if they thought they needed to. There's always an opportunity in this game. Just anything can happen here. Teleport is up for both these top laners. They are unwilling to leave the side of their teams, though, for fear of getting killed. Dragon's up in 10 seconds. Team Liquid are there. They've got the ward, so do Impulse.
Impulse have to make a last-ditch effort here. Baron. Dragon, oh, here they go, Team Impulse. Call the teleport down. Impact comes in.
He's mini Gnar, no home guard. The Q on the dominate slows him down a little bit. Dragon is up. Kog'Maw kills this so fast.
Everyone is max items. They're gonna burn it down.
Sivir's pushing mid.
Piglet's running for the
Sivir's
Nexus.
Pushing mid. Dragon 4 goes down, but he can end the game by himself. Can Phoenix they? Comes up too. Impulse has to run. They have to run.
Apollo gets
cut out. The Annie's done. They're still going. Piglet's into the base. He wants to end it right here. The Koreans of Team Liquid are pushing in. There's the turret. They're onto the Nexus. This is gonna be the game. Team Liquid tied for first place in the North American LCS.
I actually can't believe it, Phreak. I've had back-to-back days of the longest games of the split, back-to-back days of 8 dragons taken, no aspect. Team Liquid traded off for the Nexus.
Oh my god. 12,000 gold down at the end of it all. With no Nexus turrets alive or only one, you've always got to leave the option of your base getting rushed at. Team Impulse. In an hour-long game, that one lapse of judgment, didn't see that move coming. Absolutely great call by Team Liquid to say, guys, stop the ports. We'll take the Nexus.
Fifth Dragon puts so much pressure on the team. The Team Liquid able to use it in the trade and claim victory.